The internet is full of bro science, fake knowledge, half information or propaganda. Your quest of reliable, authentic health information ends here. So subscribe this channel and hit the bell icon and you never have to go anywhere else ever again.
Hello everyone, how are you today? I am Dr. Paramjeet and you're watching Dr. Education. We have started a series where we explain you blood tests and why they are done, how they are done, normal ranges. So vitamin B12 is an important blood test that measures how much vitamin B12 is there in your blood, and this is very important test. That's why we are covering this before other tests. So how is it done? See, you need blood samples, and how to prepare for it? You need to be empty stomach for at least 6 to 8 hours. You need before the test, 6 to 8 hours. So early morning sample is the best. And then certain medicines can affect the result of your test. So you need to talk to your doctor if you have to stop taking some medicines. These are like brain medicines like phenytoin, neomycin, antibiotic, colchicine, and para amino salicylic acid. These things can affect your test results. So talk to your doctor. Then how will the test? Obviously, you will get a needle prick and blood will be taken out, and the tests are done in other cases. Why will your doctor ask you to get this test? Obviously, if you have a risk of anemia, megaloblastic B12 deficiency anemia, or if you feel that there are some signs of symptoms of B12 deficiency. What are these signs of symptoms? If you have numbness and tingling numbness or in your arms and legs, if you have loss of balance, other conditions like if you have delirium or sudden confusion, loss of any brain function, dementia due to any cause, if you have absorption problem, intestinal problems, or any peripheral neuropathy, then your doctor will advise you to go through this test. What are the normal values? Normal value will be between 160 to 950 picogram per milliliter, pg per ml, or it can be in other values like 118 to 701 picomole per liter. See, normal values may vary slightly among different laboratories, and some labs can use different measurement from different samples. So you need to talk to your doctor for that, right? Abnormal results, like if you have B12 less than 160 picogram per ml or less than 118 picomole per liter, then that means that you have B12 deficiency. Even the lower side of B12 is considered as inadequate, and it should have some supplement can be done. See, an adult or older adults with a B12 level less than 100 pg per ml or less than 74 picomole per liter may also have symptoms. Deficiency should be confirmed by also checking the level of this substance in the blood of other substances like methyl malonic acid. Methyl malonic acid can also be high in case of true B12 deficiency. So what causes B12 deficiency? Obviously, we've covered this before, but let me just go through. Not having enough B12 in your diet, like you're strictly vegan, malabsorption, like if you have celiac disease, Crohn's disease, lack of intrinsic factor, and even hyperthyroidism, above normal heat production can lead to this problem. And pregnancy needs higher level of B12, and if you don't take it, then also you can have problems. Increased level of B12 is usually uncommon. Usually it is excess is removed from the urine, but this can happen if you are taking a lot of supplements, a lot of injections, or sometimes you can have liver disease such as cirrhosis and hepatitis that can increase the level of B12 in your blood. And some disorders like myeloproliferative disorders like polycythemia vera, these can do increased level. So this is all about B12 tests. I hope this was helpful. Hope you share this video and keep coming back for more such knowledgeable videos. I'm Dr. Paramjeet and you're watching Dr. Education. Stay connected and stay healthy.